You know, I looked through Gordon's case files about Harley. Her father suffered from mental illness that eventually drove him to suicide. An illness with a strong hereditary link. Mm. It's very possible she wants the serum to prevent the same thing happening to her.
If she fails, she's got one deadly plan B.
Don't sound so worried, Batman. I'm here to help.
We're almost there.
Old 5 points, 9:41 p.m.
Harley's back is against the wall. If she has Riddler's blood, she'll be incredibly dangerous.
You don't need to tell me.
Then we're on the same page.
Home sweet home, where's Catwoman?
I knew she'd be able to do it.
Who? And do what?
Catwoman.
She got out.
They threw her in this murder box before we left.
Think she's still around?
No. She's a runner. I doubt we'll be hearing from her anytime soon.
Houdini.
Harley. She must be gone already.
Do you think that means she already has the vials?
I don't know, but it's worth a look. Maybe she got scared off before she could find them.
Scared off by who? What would scare her off? Harley? Scared off of something? Oh, blood. Oh, C4?
Blood, but was this here before?
Was that the henchman that Bane killed? Or had the guy attack with a pipe or something?
Dried. Must be from when Harley shot Bane's men.
Mm. I can't see it, but I'm selecting the C4. It's over here. Pick up? Alright.
C4. Plastic explosive. Only a little, though. Must be remnants from something bigger. I don't remember Bane making bombs, and it doesn't match Freeze's M.O. Who then? Harley? John?
Even money on both.
Pretty much. The container.
Damn it.
What is it?
They're gone. The vials are gone. C4 and stolen blood. So how do those two things add up?
So...
keep looking.
Blowing up blood? What else is around here? Well, I can't walk that way. There's some kind of invisible force field, my god! I must call Green Lantern. He can help us out of this mess. Let's go up here. I don't want to look at that, but there's a device as well. Am I going to reconstruct the scene?
Does this look familiar?
We call it a liminal device, a not quite as powerful Phalanx key.
Liminal?
Some agency field ops are issued one, and if they left it, they must have been rushed. An agency team has been
here. It could have been used to access Freeze's container with the
vials. Hmm. Well, it's mine now. Liminal device. Whatever the hell liminal means. Oh, wait, no. Well, I'm gonna use the liminal device. Let me just see if there's anything else. I don't think so. No. I can't go across. No, okay. So I think the only thing left is to examine this thing. So make sure there's nothing else to look at before I do that. Because that will probably signal the end of this part.
Huh. On the side here, someone's damaged this.
Can I get in?
Was supposed to preserve him.
Obviously, it failed. Wait.
Someone damaged
Decomposition
him.
Is actually accelerated. They purposefully disabled the capsule. If that's the case, then they were trying to destroy the body.
It's textbook asset denial, but it's some sloppy work.
They were moving fast. Too fast. The rapid decay. Wonder if that's a side effect of the virus, or being in that capsule, or both.
Who knows? Poke him?
Bruce, why?
Poke, poke. Alright, let's take a bio scan. I'd poke him again, but I can't.
If Harley decides to release the virus, that sample may be the most valuable weapon we have.
Alfred, I did a bioscan of Riddler's corpse. I'm sending the data to you. The body is breaking down, so do your best with it.
Received, Bruce. It's... Oh, my.
Oh, my word.
This may take a bit of time.
So, Waller takes the blood and has Riddler's body destroyed.
That would make her the only player who could create a viable Project Lotus sample.
Yeah.
Having all the pieces to the puzzle.
Oh my god. Bruce. The Pact all had problems. Medical problems they needed solving.
And if Waller's the solution, she can make them work for her.
That's...
She's not above using leverage to get people under her thumb.
That's what it's all about?
Look what she did with my identity. Harley.
The virus!
Harley's still here all this time? Or is that someone else? Freeze, or we'll shoot. You distinctly heard a bang from in here. She's behind the covers that, oh, John. John got drunk off his butt, off his, you know.
Bruce!
Woof!
You came!
God.
Where is she, John? Where's Harley?
I don't think we've been formally introduced. Doe. John Doe. You seem kind of familiar.
Answer the question.
I asked you a question, John.
I heard you, Bruce. I do understand English.
Get a grip on yourself,
man. She was here.
Which she was here?
Yeah.
We knew she was.
Where is she now, John?
Don't puke.
This is important.
No green puke.
You got some real nerve. You know that? Buddy! Remember? The cafe. Just manipulate her, John. And then you convinced me to sabotage our whole operation.
Well, actually, I sabotaged
it. For what? She flew the coop. And I have nothing. You steered me wrong. At every turn, every bad piece of advice, everything blew up in my face.
Harley betrayed us both.
This isn't my fault. Harley betrayed us, both of us.
Yeah. But you weren't in love with her.
That's your fault.
There's no point. It's over. The Pact. The dream. Us.
Not yet, it's not. She's still out there with a deadly virus in a city full of innocent people.
Call me when you got something I care about. It always surprises me how heavy guns are. This was hers.
You know
it's
I can't.
All I have left.
It's gonna be okay, John. I promise. I care, John. You know that.
He likes when we do.
I'm nearly out of reasons to believe you anymore, Bruce.
Well, it's been real.
What are you doing, John?
Leaving.
Where are you going?
There's nothing left for me here. A lot of bad memories. And a weird smell.
John, well, that's Riddler.
I understand you want to run. I've run before. But problems, they just come with you. No matter how far you go.
Nope. Pretty sure I can get away from that smell.
Damn it, John. Listen to me. I need to find Harley.
I don't want
to
do this anymore. Not for you. Not for her. Certainly not for Gotham. I don't care.
I'm asking as your friend.
John, please. This is important. I know it hasn't been easy for us, but I am your friend.
Okay, buddy. Look, the agency was here. They took the blood. I was up here in a very dark place. They didn't find me, but Harley did. I told her what happened to Riddler. She gave me this.
I was wondering
where
that
do you think Miss Quinn is now? We'd like to find her sooner rather than later.
I want to find her. My heart can't take another kicking. I don't ever want to see her again.
It could take a kicking and keep on ticking.
She ruined me. I can't.
What you need is closure, John.
You need closure, John. Face to face. Nothing else is going to make you feel better. I promise you that.
Just can't say no to you, Bruce.
I'm glad for that.
Keep an eye on this guy. That Wayne charm gets him every time.
It's bad it doesn't work
I
on Harley.
Sure know how to spin things, all the right ways to twist my arm. It's going to take me a few hours to find her. I have to check a few places, do some things.
Okay, we'll come with you.
No. You won't.
Okay.
There will be plenty of time for John and Bruce later. This is... I need to do this alone. I'll call you when I find something.
Wait, hold on. We'd really like your help, John. Are you sure you won't reconsider us coming with you?
I did. And it's a hard pass.
Trust in him.
It's okay. Go.
Bruce, let's talk about this.
He'll come through. He's done it before.
John won't forget that.
When you first walked through that door, I honestly thought you came here to check on me.
I didn't know you were here. I swear, I think that John has a crush on...
I'm going to track down those vials in the agency's cold storage.
Too.
Be careful.
Thanks.
So what's the difference between...
Alfred, how's the bioscan analysis going?
John won't forget that.
I should have it ready for you when you arrive.
And John will remember
that. I'm on my way.
Like, what's the difference? Yeah. Wayne Manor, 10:22 p.m. Getting late. Time for Betty Bite time. Your Riddler Codex files have been updated. Ever think of driving in, like,
Al, you there?
More slowly?
I'm back. I'm taking over at the computer.
You call him Al? I don't know what you call him Al. You know, we can't go up these stairs, can we? Well, that would be a no. Alright, so we're gonna check out files and read stuff. Don't go that way either. Damn these invisible force field things. Stalactites that look obscene. Uh-oh. He dropped his tea.
Al!
We noticed that first?
No.
Is Harley
please
here?
Don't. Al, can you hear me?
Alfred?
What's the matter? Thomas, let's chat.
Thomas?
Now's the time. Won't be long.
It's
so
me.
So much to do.
Bruce.
No, Al, it's me. It's Bruce.
Yes. What would Master Bruce think about what you've done? Well, he and the Cobblepot boy are playmates.
Please wake up.
Bruce, where am I?
You're in the back cave.
Easy. You're in the cave. Take your time, think back, and tell me exactly what happened.
Cave of the Bat.
It was nothing. I was working, and I felt dizzy for a moment. I must have been more exhausted than I realized. Well, basically, that's all there is to it.
Well, we can't ignore
this. First, it's your hand shaking, and now you're passing out. We can't keep ignoring this. You need to be looked at before it gets worse. Hey, careful.
Thank you, Bruce. I'll just catch my breath. Just give me a moment, please.
Analyzing tissue sample. So he
it's
was
all nonsense.
He wasn't
what
attacked.
Is?
Freeze's magic cure-all. It doesn't work as intended. Take a look.
Well, before I take a look, let's check out the media feed and stuff like that. Is this new? Gotham citizens support GCPD Batman partnership. Despite some heavy criticism from elected officials, the Gotham City Police Department's public partnership with the masked vigilante known as Batman has been a rousing success with the city's population. Across the board, crime in the Gotham City limits has been down from the previous year, with violent crimes hitting a record low. Though some on the city council have raised concerns about Batman's hidden identity and his operation outside the restrictions of the law, it doesn't appear to be hurting public opinion. Yeah, I remember this. I don't care who he is. I care that he makes things safer, says grocery store owner Wayne Barton, whose business has seen a 50% spike in sales after dark in recent months. Council member Gail Rich is sympathetic to business owners like Barton, but she maintains, until we know who this Batman is, I don't think we can ever truly be safe. I can't drag it. That trial pushback, yeah, I remember that one too. What is the agency? Model prisoner, yeah. I wish we knew which ones were new. I was wrong about Batman. Five things about the agency. I'll read this one. I don't know if it's new or not, but I like this. There are very few things that are worth mentioning in articles like this, as nobody seems to care. Citywide bombings, distraction for a crime spree? By Kate Clark. Gotham was rocked by bombings in the early hours of this morning. While no one was hurt, the explosions left many of Gotham's citizens rattled and suspecting an act of terrorism, especially after the recent attacks of the Riddler. New information has come to light, however, that may dispel rumors of terrorism. Captain Jeffrey Sampras of the GCPD Bomb Squad confirmed that the detonated bombs were designed to maximize light and sound rather than damage, saying these explosions are meant to cause panic, not hurt people, at least not directly. Additionally, at the time of the bombing, several break-ins and homicides were reported across the city at some of Gotham's most high-profile establishments. The Gotham Brokerage, Gothcore Labs, and the GCPD's own arsenal have been confirmed by survivors as targets for the break-ins. While the GCPD has refused to comment directly on the suspected link between the explosions and the crime spree, they issued the following statement. The safety of Gotham citizens remains the police department's top priority, and rest assured that the GCPD is conducting a thorough investigation into both the recent thefts and this morning's bombings. Batman fails Gotham. Criminals at large with GCPD weapons. By Max Celeryman Maloney. Batman was on site at the GCPD arsenal while the department's armored vehicles garage fell victim to the same crime spree that terrorized the city in the early hours of this morning, but was unable to stop the thieves from killing two police officers and one mechanic and escaping with an unspecified number of APCs or armored personnel carriers. A survivor of the attack who wished to remain nameless claims that the leader of the band of thugs who broke into GCPD property and fought opposite Gotham's crime crusader was something more than human. Never seen anything like it, the survivor told the Gazette. He was huge, strong as an ox, too. He injected himself with something, I don't know what, and I swear he got even stronger. He threw Batman into the wall like it was a rag doll. Ragman, that's another one. That's right, readers. Not even the combined forces of Gotham's police department and the Dark Knight himself could stop this giant and his gang of hooligans from making off with deadly tanks capable of murdering countless civilians. I had been ready to accept that the Batman was the savior Gotham needed, but this act of incompetence is another reminder that we cannot put our trust in the vigilante who gets to keep his face hidden from the public while we live in fear of dangerous criminals every day. Oh God, all you have to do is let him help you. Riddler dead, agency confirms. By Connor Barton. All these Bartons. After a deadly reign of terror that resulted in an untold number of victims, the notorious masked madman known only as the Riddler has been confirmed dead by government law enforcement group The Agency. The agency has claimed responsibility for the takedown of one of Gotham's most notorious criminals, stating only that the Riddler was found at the harbor with civilian hostages during the explosions that shook the city, adding that he and his goons were heavily armed. So they're taking the credit, but it wasn't them. Oh, why? It's still unknown whether or not Riddler was involved in the bombings, though an inside source tells the Gazette that he is not currently being considered as a suspect, even a posthumous one, in the alleged acts of terrorism. While the agency and GCPD have yet to confirm these circumstances which led to Riddler's death, Gotham may sleep easier tonight knowing that one less murderer is on the streets. Batman missing after fight with Mammoth Lucador. Disturbing reports of service that suggest Batman Gotham's defender may have been mortally wounded in his early hours of this morning at the GCPD's arsenal. An eyewitness and survivor of the fatal assault on the arsenal said, Batman was hurt bad. Their leader did a real number on him. I tried to get him help, but I don't know if I got there in time. Honestly, I don't know if anyone could survive a concrete slab falling on them. Not even Batman. I'm sorry, guys. I'm really tired. Their leader is described as an enormous man with tattoos and superhuman strength wearing a luchador, or Mexican wrestler, mask, as confirmed by several witnesses to this morning's incursion. This still unnamed man should be considered armed and dangerous, according to the GCPD, who also urged civilians not to approach him and call the police immediately if seen. Yeah, he is dangerous, not armed, though. When asked if Batman was hurt or killed by this superhuman criminal, the GCPD spokesperson told the Gazette, while the police department has partnered with Batman in the past, we do not represent him in any official capacity and can neither confirm nor deny claims that he may have been injured in this morning's assault. Oh, jeez, guys. There has yet to be any sighting of the caped vigilante since this morning's attack. I remember this one. The guy died. Hmm. Excuse me. Bruce Wayne on a Decline by Mark Phillips. Gotham billionaire and infamous playboy Bruce Wayne was spotted today at local watering hole and dive bar The Stacked Deck. Patrons claim to have seen him drinking with a thin green-haired man identified only as John. This consorting with Gotham's seedier underbelly is just another in a line of negative publicity the young business tycoon has been garnering. After his assault on one-time Wayne Enterprises CEO Oswald Cobblepot last year, which briefly landed Wayne in Arkham Asylum, the billionaire has had to contend with an investigation into the deadly explosion at Wayne Tower, which led to the death of one of the head of Wayne Enterprises Research and Development, Lucius Fox, as well as his recent implication in the assault of Arago Casino owner Rumi Mori. Speculations have begun that the revelation of Thomas Wayne's criminal past has taken too great a toll on the Bachelor Playboy, and that he may be on the verge of snapping completely. Wayne Enterprises' stock still holds steady despite Wayne's erratic actions of late, but analysts are keeping a close eye on the market. Gordon demoted to Deputy Operations. In a massive fall from grace, Gotham's recently promoted Commissioner Gordon has already managed to lose his title, being demoted to Deputy Operations at the GCPD. In a press statement released earlier today, the GCPD informed the public, ex-Commissioner Gordon has served Gotham and her citizens to the fullest of his capabilities. His demotion is not a reflection of his character or his ability to do his job. Deputy Ops is extremely lucky to have a man of his caliber on their team. When asked why the Gordon was demoted, if he was so capable in his role, the police department refused to comment, stating that the details were part of an active investigation and releasing them to the public would only jeopardize current police efforts. Jim Gordon has done more for this city than anyone else in the force, Officer Rene Montoya told the Gazette. If you ask me, it's a disgrace. I owe my life to that man, and to see him treated like this, it's just wrong. Though a few names have been floated as possible candidates for the role of police commissioner, the GCPD has yet to name a replacement. Agency takes over crime spree investigation. While no one was hurt, the explosions left many of Gotham's citizens rattled and suspecting an act of terrorism, especially after the recent attacks of the Riddler. DCPD confirmed today that they have given the agency control of their investigation into the recent break-ins throughout the city. At least 12 people have been confirmed dead in relation to these events, including 3 police officers and 5 city employees. Confusion about and within the investigation has been a cause of concern for Gotham citizens. Residents are calling for a stronger police presence throughout the city, as well as answers about the attacks themselves. So far, no suspect has been apprehended. Historically, the agency and GCPD have rarely worked in tandem. It was a joint investigation decades ago that pitted the two against the Riddler, one which ultimately ended in failure. Many have called into question the organization's ability to effectively deal with the group responsible for citywide attacks. A GCPD spokesperson told the Gazette, while the agency might be leading the investigation, rest assured they have Gotham PD's full cooperation. More on this story to follow as information is made available. Now this I remember. This I remember as well. Yeah, look at this. Exclusive: Riddler murdered, by Connor Barton. A source within GCPD refutes the agency's claim that they're responsible for the death of the terrorist known as the Riddler, and has revealed to the Gazette that the Riddler was already dead when the agency arrived on the scene, and that the vigilante Batman was present at that time. This calls into question all of the agency's statements in regards to this matter. Earlier, it was confirmed by the GCPD coroner that the Riddler's cause of death was poisoning. The substance was a lethal combination of psychoactive drugs injected directly into the bloodstream. The fact that Batman was on scene before the arrival of the agency suggests he, and not the enforcement group, was responsible for Riddler's apprehension. However, some are speculating he was also responsible for the murder. The possibility of the Caped Crusader breaking his well-known moral code to put an end to the Riddler threat lies heavy in the hearts of Gotham City citizens. More troubling still are the agency and GCPD's refusal to launch an investigation into Riddler's murder. Any claims made that Riddler's death involved foul play are entirely erroneous, said Amanda Waller, director of the agency, in response to the GCPD's leaks revelation. The events aboard the Lady of Dublin occurred as the agency has previously stated. An internal affairs official of the Gotham Police Department reached out to the Gazette to say, "We are going to be conducting a thorough internal investigation to route out the source of these unofficial leaks. These unauthorized reports go against GCPD policy but endanger active investigations." Opinion: law enforcement playing hot potato with Gotham attackers. 24 hours have passed since yesterday's massacre, and not a single suspect has been brought into custody. Not by the GCPD, not by the agency, and certainly not by Batman. The only perpetrator identified in the attacks was a distinctive, massive man dressed as a Mexican wrestler. A source within GCPD says the suspect is known as Bane, yet both the local police and the agency have refused to go public with this information. This is a level of incompetence that hasn't been seen in Gotham until recently. Some were leery of this shadowy agency taking over the investigation into the recent acts of terrorism, citing the agency's failure to apprehend the Riddler during his initial crime spree in Gotham. Their efforts, or lack thereof, in apprehending those responsible for the brokerage, arsenal, and Gothcore attacks have confirmed their ineptitude. The hearts and minds of Gotham citizens are nervous. While the agency and Gotham City Police Department are busy playing hot potato with Gotham's criminal cases, the murderer of Arsenal walks free. Free to terrorize Gotham with the weapons he and his villainous associates have already used against the agency itself in an attack on one of their convoys. Batman is missing or presumed dead since his face-off with Bane, and law enforcement is unable to bring these terrorists to justice. It's clear to this reporter that Gotham's citizens have no one to rely on but themselves. Be safe out there. Exclusive: Riddler body stolen from agency convoy. The Gazette can now confirm that the Riddler's body has been taken from agency custody and that it was the target of the mass convoy's attack last night. When asked why the agency was in possession of the Riddler's corpse, Henry Chang, an agency spokesman, said, "We don't know where these leaks are coming from, but wherever they are, they do not speak for the agency or the Gotham City Police Department. Anything else they say should be regarded as unreliable." Chang refused to comment further. Speculations were raised in regards to the agency's credibility when the Gazette published an article calling into question the validity of one of their earlier statements. It was first erroneously claimed by the agency that they were responsible for capturing Riddler, resulting somehow in the man's death. With the agency moving Riddler's body, notice sometimes the agency, sometimes the is capitalized, and, the agency sometimes is not. It's speculated that the government group might have been trying to take the corpse out of the hands of local authorities. This would prevent access to key evidence and set back an attempt to properly investigate Riddler's death. The outcry and hostility from Gotham citizens against the agency has increased as falsehoods are increasingly brought to light. Agency Director Amanda Waller was unavailable for an interview for this article. GCPD and agency spotted at Wayne Tower. Eyewitness accounts state that both GCPD and the agency were seen entering Wayne Tower this morning. It is currently unknown what they were investigating, but less than an hour later, both groups departed without making any arrests or public statements. This has brought into question why such a show of force would be necessary at one of Gotham's most prominent buildings. The only known joint effort between the agency and the GCPD is the investigation into yesterday's attacks, now being referred to as acts of terrorism by authorities. What connection this has to Wayne Enterprises and potentially CEO Bruce Wayne is still unknown. Concern over Wayne's mental state has bled into discussions about the future of his family's business. Last year, he was implicated in a high-profile assault on Oswald Cobblepot and was temporarily admitted... temporary stint. In Arkham Asylum. Okay, we have got a lot of spelling and grammar errors here. As of this writing, no charges have been filed against Wayne. We've reached out to the GCPD, the agency, and Wayne Enterprises. Each organization has refused to comment. Gordon fired from GCPD. GCPD confirmed today that Deputy Commissioner of Operations James Gordon has been fired from the force. The majority of sources are blaming Gordon's rocky track record, which only recently led to his demotion. What? From his position as commissioner. Majority of sources. Not the GCPD themselves. They said it had nothing to do with his character or his work record or anything like that. Still others are pointing to workplace tensions between the GCPD and the agency as the cause of Gordon's dismissal. Ding, ding, ding. Getting closer. The Gazette followed up on these comments, reaching out to both the GCPD and the agency for further explanation. The GCPD issued this brief statement. We appreciate all Gordon has done for the GCPD and wish him the best moving forward. The agency, while offering more clarity in a response, still leaves us with many questions. Given the current climate in Gotham, a change in leadership is needed. We commend James Gordon for his years of service to the city and people of Gotham. Longtime supporters of Gordon have spoken out to the press, breaking protocol in an unprecedented move. Detective Renee Montoya said about the dismissal, "It's disgraceful, that's what it is. It's putting politics over policing. No candidates for the position of Deputy Ops have been announced." Exclusive: Catwoman narrowly evades GCPD, by Bill Garcia. Gotham's most notorious stray cat, the career thief known as Catwoman, is reportedly back in town and already causing a stir. After a year-long hiatus, Catwoman is once more painting the town red and blue, with police sirens flooding the streets. The GCPD, who in the past have failed to apprehend Catwoman, are holding nothing back in their pursuit, an inside source says. We had a strong lead. We could have had her. Someone obviously tipped her off, but you can bet we'll find out who it was. Next time, she's ours. Our source refused to elaborate on who the GCPD suspects warned Catwoman, or if they suspect it was a leak from within the GCPD. As always, we encourage anyone who knows what Catwoman might have holed up to please come forward. We will release more details following an internal review. As an incentive, a generous reward is being offered by a group of private citizens, museums, and corporations, all victims of Catwoman's international crimes. While this commitment by authorities to arrest Catwoman is laudable, it also raises concerns that police resources are being diverted from more pressing matters. The individuals responsible for the brokerage, arsenal, and Goth Corps attacks, as well as the ambush on an agency convoy, are still at large. One could argue that, unless Catwoman is somehow involved with these terrorists, she can be put on the back burner. I, for one, am more concerned for the safety of my children than the safety of my jewelry. Bruce Wayne implicated in assault. Why no arrest? By Mark Phillips. Okay, hopefully this is the last one. The negative publicity for Bruce Wayne, billionaire playboy, continues with Wayne's latest in a string of erratic behavior. An inside source at the GCPD implicates Wayne in trespassing on a crime scene in Gotham's Lower East End, resulting in the assault of an unnamed officer. What was Wayne doing in the Lower East End? Eyewitnesses suggest Wayne wasn't alone. For someone of Wayne's caliber, it's plausible this was thoughtless thrill-seeking gone wrong. Then again, it's clear by now that Wayne is no stranger to Gotham's less savory corners, with his recent appearance at the Stack Deck Bar as proof. The fact remains that the GCPD has probable cause to investigate Wayne, or at least bring him in for questioning, yet have not done so. The Gazette reached out to Wayne Enterprises, GCPD, and the agency to inquire whether the authorities show a force of Wayne Tower had anything to do with Wayne's nocturnal activities. Each organization refused to comment. Why are they not telling the public? Is Wayne embroiled in another scandal? And will this one diffuse like that of last year, or is this just the beginning of another dark chapter in Wayne's life? Breaking news. Police shut down Bodhi Spa, by Kate Clark. passersby and frequenters of the spa are baffled by the sudden closure of its doors and are wondering how long it will last. Combined GCPD and agency forces have created a perimeter, apparently as part of an ongoing investigation within the spa, but the exact cause of their presence is unknown. That is that, okay. Downtown's Bodhi Spa is currently a hub of police activity. Clients are not... And... Geez, how many? I might have read the next one. Not sure. Clients and employees who were present at the time of the authorities' arrival were quickly escorted from the site. However, the Gazette did talk to one employee leaving the scene. The masseuse, who looked pale and shaken, claimed she wasn't sure what happened, just that people got hurt. I was in the middle of a massage. I didn't see anything. Just some guy who stuck his head into the room. But I thought that was a prank. Joker. He said something about a secret lab. I don't know. I'm sorry. In the meantime, testy clients have taken to social media, condemning Bodhi Spa for refusing to give refunds for appointments canceled on account of these events. However, a Bodhi Spa representative promises to reschedule these appointments as soon as the current matter is resolved. More on this story to follow as information is made available. Is the Agency Above the Law? By Mark Phillips. The secretive government organization known as the Agency has become a common sight in Gotham. While their presence in Gotham is a justifiable answer to the rise of violent crime in the city, complaints of the agency's tendency to abuse its authority have poured into the mayor's office. The Gazette itself has received numerous letters lambasting the agency. Dock owners in particular are up in arms after multiple illegal searches of their private property, for which the agency offered no explanation. It's like they answer to no one. I've complained to the mayor, the police, the state legislature. I even threatened lawsuits. But even the lawyers I contacted wanted nothing to do with these people. It's unbelievable.
I couldn't believe it. It's unbelievable.
God, the last article? Now Gothamites have a new reason to question the agency's methods. Apparently, in connection to the current investigation at the Bodhi Spa, the agency is closely monitoring travel in and out of the city. Public officials are encouraging citizens to cooperate with the agency's demands. Gotham security is the agent's priority. The sooner the agency finishes its work, the sooner Gotham citizens can return to their normal activities. Vigil Plan for Victims of Violence by Max Maloney. A vigil is being planned to honor those civilians, officers, and agents who have lost their lives or been wounded by recent acts of terror. While the threats facing Gotham affect all of us, the families of these individuals feel the fear and pain of these attacks in a very personal way. Many have cited a need to stand together as a sign of unity, well, this is it, and defiance in the face of adversity. However, some believe a public vigil is a bad idea and only gives these violent criminals an easy target. But the GCPD promises a strong presence at the vigil and encourages Gothamites to attend. God, they really gotta proofread this stuff. At the ceremony, family members of the fallen will also pay their respects, and religious leaders will offer words of guidance. My dad, Chip Locke, who died in the attack on the police arsenal, says Susanna Locke, Chip's daughter, who's expecting her first child in just over a month. We miss him so much. We're all devastated he won't be here to meet his granddaughter. But I know she'll be proud, too, knowing her granddad died helping others. And that's why this vigil is so important, insists Susanna. We owe it to them to be there. Alright, let's see updates for Codex.